I'm in beautiful Santa Monica, California, super bike friendly, lots of people commute to work, and I ran into the Public bicycle shop just downtown. It opened in March 2016, really nice place, really awesome employees, and of course they have a couple of electric bikes. This is the D8 electric. It's built around a very similar frame that they offer, non-electric, but of course it's a diamond, and that's what the D stands for, kind of the high step. And an 8-speed. So up here we've got 8-speed Shimano Claris trigger shifters, and then back here the Claris drivetrain, the derailleur. I believe it's 11 to 32 teeth back here, maybe 39 teeth up front. Really relaxed bike, a lot of fun to cruise around on this thing. Kind of an angled up stem, a little bit of a riser bar, comfortable saddle, steel frame. Steel bars, steel stem, lots of steel on this thing. Aluminum rack, aluminum fenders, aluminum crank arms, and aluminum chain cover. I love that too. There's a lot of utility in their bikes when they're kind of set up like this. They also have bikes with drop bars and stuff, but to me, this is, I guess they called it the safety frame years ago when they switched from penny farthing. And a lot of these bikes that they have, they kind of resemble like British and French, European styles. Now, the geometry is really set up more American style, so it feels like what I'm used to. And I guess apparently Dutch bikes and things are raised a little bit more traditionally. I haven't tried all of those other bikes, but it's neat to kind of get a little bit of a historical perspective. There's a guy at the shop named Mikey, really awesome guy, and he was answering all my questions, giving me feedback about just the details on all this thing. It's like, okay, we got like, you know, three riser stacks here, and you know, what's the deal with the disc brakes? I was commenting on how the Avids are really nice, BB7s, because you can adjust them like with your fingers. You don't need to bust out the tools and pull on the cable. They're mechanical, so you know, it requires a little bit more hand strength. It'd be nice if this was a hydraulic upgrade, but 160 millimeter rotors, that's nice. You know, it's a little bit more usable than the caliper brakes. And he was saying, yeah, that is really nice. I noticed that because this uses the BionX hub motor, gearless direct drive, it's a little bit larger, so they get mechanical advantage. It's just magnets, there's no gears inside. But you can see that it's a little bit harder to adjust this rear brake in particular. There's no quick release skewer or anything. I think it has like a hardened steel axle. It's a little bit stronger, but same at the front. There's no quick release. It's kind of a maybe a city bike in that sense. No quick release on the seat post either, or the seat tube. So you could take this, you could park it at a rack, and it's a little bit more tamper resistant, which is nice. Faux leather saddle, a little bit larger, and apparently it has some memory foam qualities to it. Felt pretty good when I was riding here. We've got the faux leather grips, matching, stitched. You know, nice stuff. This comes in gloss black, as you see here, two sizes, about 18 and about 21. I'm on the larger 21, and I'm 5'9", and it's working for me, in part because of those riser bars. You know, that's a big plus for me. Just brings them up a little bit, just maybe the geometry. It's a nice experience, and even the tires and stuff here, they're a little bit larger. These are Kendas. 700 by 42C. I love the reflective sidewalls. I like the painted double-walled, like mid-dish rims too. And up front, I think these are like 14 gauge, but in the rear, 12 gauge spokes, a little bit thicker, and that's designed to, you know, handle the added weight and power of a hub motor like we have here. So the hub motors are cool when you're shifting gears a lot because it doesn't interfere with your drivetrain at all. Mid drives, you know, they bring the weight forward a little bit more and stuff, but they don't offer regenerative braking potential, and this one actually has it. You got regen, it's gonna save your brake pads a little bit, and it's just nice. It's just a smooth stop. Doesn't really give you a whole lot of extra power. It might help to offset some of the increased weight of the hub motor. This is like 8 or 9 pounds. And the battery pack itself is about 8 pounds as well. So if you're moving this thing, you know, I've noticed I kind of pick up on the handlebars and the bike sort of tips backwards a little bit. It sort of wants to fall over. The weight's high, it's in the rear. This is a style that some companies are moving away from, but I still like and appreciate the aesthetic, and you can easily put some panniers or a bag on the back and it hides it. You know, yeah, there's a big hub motor back here, but again, you get the really, it's just, it's durable. It's a durable setup. You don't have gears in there. It doesn't sound like there's any ring. It's just smooth. It's quiet. And I like that. And this one uses a torque sensor built right into the hub. So as you're pedaling, you get a really fluid output of power in addition to trigger throttle. So I'm going to get to that in a minute. But I also want to comment on and compliment that they've got a chain guide. So plates, metal plates on both sides of that front chain ring. It's going to keep the chain from bouncing off. And then this nice little cover I mentioned earlier just keeps your pants and things from getting too dirty. So I was talking about weight a second ago. It's not the lightest weight bike out there. It's got all these accessories, steel frame and stuff. It's about 55 pounds, you know, which is like, okay, that's kind of manageable. The specs are 350 watts for the motor. That's nominal output. 40 newton meters of torque, pretty decent. And then we've got the battery up here, 48 volt battery, 8.8 amp hours. It's actually it's pretty good. I'd say it's above average. The battery is removable, so you can charge it on or off the bike. You just put the key in there, and then this plug kind of pops out, and you slide it backwards. There's a nice handle and an integrated light, which is really cool for safety. And when you're putting it back on, you just slide it, and then you clink, you like push that in, and it locks it. It's pretty intuitive. It's pretty nice. The rack is sort of a bolt-on design, so you might want to check those screws occasionally just to make sure everything's good. I haven't heard a lot of rattling with the fenders or anything. Again, aluminum. Seems like the bike works pretty well. I think these racks are rated about 45 pounds, and with the battery being 8 pounds, sort of estimate it's like, well, how many more pounds you want to put on? Just keep an eye on it. That's why I'm pointing out all these different, you know, I guess the attachment points. I like that there's a little neoprene cable cover right here because you do have some extra cables running around the bike. It's not as purpose-built as some of the other electric bikes I see that have cables run through the frame. In this case, they're just tacked on below the down tube, but it gets the job done. And because this is a black one, the other model they have is Nexty or something. It's sort of a step through, a little bit of a lower top tube, and it's a navy blue. Cable's still blending with that one. I think they're positioned pretty well, but they're taking the public style and the existing platform, and they're adding BionX, and I think it works pretty well, but there are a little trade-offs. This bike's $21.99. It started out a little bit more expensive than that, but I think they've dropped the price. We're at the end of 2016 right now, and you know, there's always innovation happening in sales and stuff. Public, they ship direct to consumers, and they also have these outlets like in Santa Monica here. So it's kind of cool when you can get up close and touch the bike. I think they're based in San Francisco, and they ship these ready to ride in like a really big box. So it's like pretty much ready to go. You just straighten out the handlebars, put the pedals on, and everything's been tuned and set up right. So I really love that. And again, you know, at that $2,200 price point, you're getting, I think, up to a 3-year warranty on the battery and the motor. That's a BionX thing. If you register through public and stuff, that's a lot. That's definitely like leading in terms of time. And then they also have a 30-day money-back guarantee where you get it and you're like, do I want it? Does it work? So that's pretty nice. Some really good customer service that way. Love the kickstand too. This is Pletcher. Pretty sturdy, pretty burly, and it is adjustable length. Sometimes you get the bikes that are really tipped over. Also stainless nipples, just gonna add some strength, and the rims being, you know, it's nice. It's a nice aesthetic. There's something really beautiful about these bikes, and you know, it takes a second to really appreciate it. But it is, you know, steel frame, steel fork, rigid. And the tires are bigger than road, but they're not the most comfortable, softest beach cruiser tires out there. So that's an area where you could potentially improve this. It's a 27.2 millimeter seat post, and you could get yourself a thud buster or a body float, and that would add some real comfort, especially when you're going longer distances at higher speeds. Top speed on this is 20 miles per hour. Let's talk about the display and everything. Once the battery's on and plugged in here, that's it. Like, you're ready to go. We just come up here to the display, press one of these buttons, and you can see it come to life. It lights up and it says, okay, how fast are we going? Zero, you know, distance 18.8, and you can kind of arrow up or down, and you've got four levels of like regen. So you can actually pedal this thing and generate electricity. It's not very efficient, but that's something people ask all the time when they're new to e-bikes. They're like, whoa, can I charge it by pedaling? It's like, yeah, you're gonna be wasting energy. Like, in the scheme of things, depending on what type of food you're eating, and it's just not very efficient. But it's, again, it saves your brake pads, and it might simulate hills if you don't live in a place that has hills like Santa Monica. So that's an option. And then we've got four levels of assist, so you can build the power, you can get a lot of assistance. The higher you go, of course, the more power you're getting, but it's not going to be as efficient. You're not going to get the range. You're not going to maximize that. So keep that in mind. Over here, you can see the throttle. And if I push it, nothing is happening. I love that this has a throttle, by the way. So it's a class 2. It really helps you get going once you're at 2 miles per hour. That's a safety thing. You have to get the bike moving. It's like then the throttle will start working. So we'll show that a little bit later. The pad's just real small, real easy to reach, clean, keeps the cockpit looking nice. I love that. This is backlit display. It's symmetrical, so you can kind of use both sides. If you're left-handed, you can swap the sort of the controls, which is really neat. I love that there are a bunch of increments on this battery infographic, and that again, if you pull the left brake lever, it has an integrated motor inhibitor and it switches to generate. You see that little G that pops up? So you've got regenerative braking as well as regen modes. Just a nice setup, and the display's removable. So if you go to a place, you're parking it, and you don't want this getting a lot of sunlight, getting scratched potentially, you can swap, you know, pull it right off. There's a little tab at the bottom, you just slide it up. And again, the battery locks securely, but it's also removable for weight savings, and just really nice. And look at this, two sets of bottle cage bosses, really nice. Back here, there's another boss, and I was asking Mikey, like, what's the deal with this? And he said, oh, that's so that you can put a cafe lock. You know, it's this C-clamp thing, and it has like a skewer that goes like right through so people can't move the bike. They could still pick it up and run away with it, but it's the cafe quick stop lock a lot of European bikes have. And of course, all the bosses for fenders and the rack and everything. It's really cool. Okay. Pop that kickstand up. Let's go for a ride. I really love this dolphin mural. That's why I'm doing this review, like, right in a busy area. Maybe we should head down to the beach and just check that out. It's a really wonderful place to ride. Okay. Just pedaling along. Definitely feeling the juice because I'm in the highest level of assist. Whoa. Make the green light yellow. Just shift some gears. Oh, not gonna make that one. So the disc brakes do a pretty good job. You know, it requires a little bit more effort than if they were hydraulic. That's one of the complaints. But I love that they're silver. You know, everything on this bike is pretty beautiful and matching. I talked about it being rear heavy, you know, but just how quiet it is. I know it's a busy place around here. I'm not able to get the camera too close to that hub motor, but it really is quiet. This is one of the most quiet systems I know of. Offers pretty good torque. You're just trading off with, you know, it's a little bit more premium. It adds to the cost. And then the weight thing, 55 pounds, you know, that's something to think about. Riding around town, you know, 8 speeds is pretty decent. I like the triggers, but that's probably based on having this window and using that space why they went ahead and put the display and the trigger throttles over on the left. So usually it's on the right. And here's their shop. It's the public bike shop. Let's go in and check it out. This is one of those moments I'm lifting at the front and the back just wants to kind of tip over. So be careful with that when you're moving this thing. So this is the shop. You can see a bunch of other awesome looking public bikes. Is this it? This is the public D8i that this platform's built off of? Is it okay if I go in the back? I wanted to show the bigger boxes, the ready to ride box.
Sure.
Mikey's over here truing a wheel. Looking good, man. Sweet. Yeah, this is, see how much larger that is versus, yeah. In this case, the wheels probably off of it, and yeah, that's awesome. How much extra do you pay for this kind of setup?
For the ready to ride, right now we're having a special for it's free.
Really?
Yeah, so if you go order something online right now, we have a special sort of free ready to ride, but usually it's $135.
Okay, it's good to know. People might be watching this.
Ships to your door, 99% assembled. and all you have to do is put in the stem and then tighten the pedals in. And we, the tools are in here to do that too, and instructions.
We were talking earlier just about the guy that started the company and that he used to do some other stuff. Can you give me the rundown again real quick?
Yeah, Rob. His name's Rob Forbes. Okay. He started Design Within Reach, which is a furniture store, mm-hmm. Custom furniture, really beautiful stuff.
Yeah.
Sold the company and opened up a bike store.
Wow.
With the European style in mind.
Let's go back out and it's so beautiful to see all these different colors and just the shop is kind of a work of art.
Yeah.
The different handlebars, the different, you said Brooks saddles that you can get. And
yeah, we have the Brooks saddles here, Brooks grips. I like to, the place is kind of split in half. We got our bikes over here, and then everything over here is kind of how you can accessorize your bike.
The wine carrier?
Huge seller. People love that thing. We put it in the window display and people come right in asking right about the wine holder.
That's fantastic. Well, Sean, you've been super helpful today. And, you know, it was fun to get to check out the electric bikes. The things are zipping around. I'm also going to check out the other one. That's the M8. And what did you say that the Mixty?
The Mixty.
That's like the French design with the French.
Yeah.
Got it. It's beautiful. I really appreciate it. For the full write-up on these bikes, I'll see you back at ElectricBikeReview.com. And of course, ride safe.